हेलो एवरीबॉडी, टुडे नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट टुडेज आईआईटी पेपर. ओके, सो आई हैव द सॉफ्ट कॉपी हार्ड कॉपी ऑफ टुडेज क्वेश्चन पेपर. सो फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन वॉज गिवन अ रैशनल नंबर -5/9. दिस रैशनल नंबर कैन अल्सो बी नोन एज अ नैचुरल नंबर. डेफिनेटली दिस इज नॉट अ नैचुरल नंबर. This is not a whole number because natural number starts from 1 and whole number starts from 0. So all positive integers are there. Fraction, this is not a fraction because negative, okay, this is negative number. And this is a real number because real number contains all the positive and negative fractions, okay. So this is first answer is D, okay, 51 is D. Now next question. The number 1.0, this, if you'll see the decimal representation of this number, then that is an irrational number because decimal representation is non-terminating and non-repeating also. Understood? So this is an irrational number. Okay. So D1 is the correct answer. Now see next question number 53 is -7 + 4√7 - 3√7. Okay, so we can do this because these are both the terms contains irrational factor which is same root 7. So if you solve this, you will get -7 + 4√7 - 3√7. It will be root 7. Okay, so here one irrational factor is still irrational factor is there. Okay, so this is an irrational number. This is whatever after solving you will get, this is an irrational number. So B is the correct answer. Okay, now question number 54 is √5 + √7 (brackets). So here a plus b bracket square we can use. So a plus b bracket square gives us a square, means √5² will be 5, √7² will be 7, and the product of these two multiply by 2. So √5 × √7 will be √35, and it's we need to multiply by 2. So 5 + 7 = 12 + 2√35. Okay, so this is correct answer. So option D is the correct option. Okay, now question number 55 is the three rational numbers between 3 and 4. Okay, 3 and 4, they are asking three rational numbers. So we will 3 + 1, we will add 1 in 3, that is 4. So by this 4 we will multiply to the given number. So 3 multiply by 4 and divide by 4. Okay, and this 4 also we will multiply by 4 and we will divide by 4. Okay, so here we will get 4 threes are 12 by 4, and 4 fours are 16 by 4. Okay, so 12 and 16, in between them, see which are coming after 12, 13 by 4, then 14 by 4 and 15 by 4. So for question number 55, B is the correct answer. Okay, next question number 56, which of the following is irrational number? Okay, so irrational, see here, which of the following is irrational number? So root 16 will be 4, √12/3 means √12/3. So 12 we can factorize, that is 12 4 threes are 12 divided by 3. So if you will do this, 4 threes are 12, so 4 × 3 / √3. So 4 is the perfect square, so we can take that outside. So that will be 2√3 / √3. So √3 we can cancel. So 2 we can write in the form of fraction or in the form of rational number. Okay, so root 12, see next, root 12 we can do 4 threes are 12, so 4 we can take outside, that is 2√3. So but this contains the irrational factor √3. So they are asking which of the following is an irrational number. So √12 is irrational, and last one option, √100 is the 10. So we can write this is in the form of rational number. This also we can write. So √12 is the correct answer. So C option is the correct option. Okay, next, which of the following is equal to x cube? So x raised to 6 - x cube. okay, this is first option. We want answer x cube. So if you'll see here, this is x raised to 6 divided by x cube. So here division is there, and both bases are same. So x raised to 6 minus 3, so is equal to x raised to 3. So C is the correct answer. Then after this, a rational number between root 2 and root 3, question number 58. A rational number between root 2 and root 3. We know the value of root 2. Value of root 2 is 1.41, and value of root 3 is 1.73. Okay, we have seen this. These are the irrational factors. So in between them, which is coming, if you'll observe, this 1.5 is coming, because when you will put here 0 or here 0 or here 0, see 1.90 is not coming in between. Okay, and 1.50 is coming in between. So this is the correct answer. Okay, and this is 180 is after 73. So that is not correct. So C is the correct option. Okay, now after this, question number 59 is, which of the following is an irrational number? So again, this is first one is the correct answer, because decimal representation is not repeating, non-terminating. Okay, this is terminated. This is 1416, means decimal, whole decimal part is repeating due to this bar. Okay, here 16 is repeating, and our definition of irrational number is, its decimal representation should not be repeated and should not be terminated. Okay, so A is the correct answer. Okay, now after this, root 12 and root 15. So root 12 and root 15, suppose we will multiply root 12 into 15, so we can factorize it. So 4 into 3 and 15, we can write 3 into 5. So 4 is the perfect square, it will come outside. 3 is in pair, so it will come outside, under root 5. So 3 to the 6, 6 root 5 is the correct answer. So which one is the correct answer? B. B is the correct answer. Okay. Question number 61 is, the if the radius is radius of a cylinder is halved and height is doubled, then what will be the curved surface area? Okay, so what is first curved surface area is equals to 2 pi r h CSA. When radius is r and height is h, that time curved surface area we use 2 pi r h. And just they have told us radius is halved, means 2 pi radius is halved, means it we need to divide by 2, and height is doubled, h is equals to 2 times h. Okay, so what will be the curved surface area? So this is CSA 1 and CSA 2. So here again we can cancel 2. So again, what is going to remain? 2 pi rh. So in both the cases, curved surface areas are same. Okay, so B is the correct answer. Okay, then 62. Question number 62. See here, the ratio of volume of cylinder, volume of cone, and volume of hemisphere. Volume of cylinder we use pi r square h is to volume of hemisphere, volume of cone 1 by 3 pi r square h, and volume of hemisphere is equal to 2 by 3 pi r cube. Okay, so here what is getting? 1 by 1 is to 1 by 3 is to 2 by 3. So here we will multiply by 3, we need to make denominator same. So here what is getting? 3 upon 3 is to 1 upon 3 is to 2 upon 3. So what is final remain? Denominators are same, so ratio will be 3 is to 1 is to 2. So this answer is correct. D option is correct. Okay. Question number 63, see, if a right circular cone has radius 4 cm and slant height 5 cm, what is its volume? Okay. Radius is given 4 cm and slant height, means L, is equals to 5. And to find out volume, which formula we use? 1 by 3 pi r square h. So we must know h. So we need to find out. So how we will find out? L square is equal to r square plus h square. So L is given 5 square is equal to r is 4 square plus h square. So 25 minus this 16, 4 square will come this side. 16 is equal to h square. So h square is equal to 9. So h is equal to 3. H is equal to 3 centimeters. Okay. Now we have to find out volume. So 1 by 3 pi r square h. So 1 by 3 into pi I am keeping as it is because pi is given in the options. So multiply by r square is, r is 4 multiplied by 4 into height is 3. Okay, so here 3 will be cancelled, 4 is 16, 16 pi is the correct answer. So option A is the correct answer. Okay, question number 64. The radius of hemisphere, the radius of a hemisphere is r. What is its volume? Radius is given r. Okay, what is its volume? And hemisphere we use formula 2/3 pi r³. Okay, so this is application based, very simple question. Understood? So question number 64, B is the correct answer. Okay, now what is the total surface area of a hemisphere of radius r? What is the total surface area? Total surface area means we need to think about curved surface area plus area of this base. So curved surface area is 2 pi r² plus area of circle is pi r square. So 2 pi r² plus pi r square will be 3 pi r². So D is the correct option. Question number 66. Question number 66 is, if the radius of a sphere is doubled, radius of the, then what is the ratio of the surface area? Okay, if the radius of the sphere is doubled. Okay, so radius is suppose r. So what is the formula for surface area of sphere? Surface area of sphere is equals to which formula we use? We use 4 pi r². Now they have told us radius is doubled. So new surface area will be 4 pi, radius is double means 2 r². So 4 pi, 2 r means 4, 2 square is 4 r square. So 4 are 16 pi r square. Okay, so this is the new surface area and this is old surface area and we have to find out ratio. So 4 pi r square divided by 16 pi r square. So pi r square will be cancelled. 4 ones are 4, 4 are 16. So 1 is to 4. So C is the correct option. Okay. Now question number 67 C. Two right circular cones of equal curved surface areas have slant heights in the ratio of 3:5. Find the ratio of their radii. Okay. So what they have told us, two right circular cones of equal curved surface. Okay, means curved surface area, this is first, and curved surface area 2. Both the curved surface areas are equal, have slant heights in the ratio 3:5. Slant height is given. So curved surface area, which formula use? Pi r l. So here we will say r1 and l1, and here pi r2 l2. Curved surface area we use formula pi r l. Okay, so now here pi we can cancel because value remains same. So r1 upon this r2 is equal to l2 upon this l1 is equals to, what is going to get? L2 upon L1 is equals to 5/3. This L1, L2 is 5 and L1 is 3. So that is the correct option. Okay. So C is the correct answer here. Question number 68 is, in the cylindrical container, the base radius is 8 cm. If the height of the water level is 20 cm, find the volume of the water in the container. Okay, so radius is given 8 cm and height is given 20 cm. Okay, so here we need to find out volume. Pi r square h is equal to 22/7 into 8 multiplied by 20. Height is given. Okay, so here it will get you, this product will get 28,160 divided by 7. So 4,022.85. Okay, so we need to convert into liter because options are given in liter. So when you will divide by 1000, that time what you will get? 4.022. So which one is the correct answer? B. This 4 is getting here. So B is the correct answer. Understood? Next, a well with 10 meter inside diameter is dug 14 meter deep. Now earth taken out of it is spread all around it to make an embankment of height 4 integer 2/3 meters. Find the width of the embankment. okay, width we have to find out. Means condition is like that. See, well is given. Well is 10 meter inside diameter. Diameter is 10 meter. Is dug 14 meter deep. Is dug 14 meter deep. Means this height is given 14 meter. Earth taken out. Whatever earth is taken out from this, it is spread all around to it to make an embankment. It is spread like this. Mean embankment of 4 integer. Its height is given 4 integer 2 by 3. And then find the width. Width means here we have to find out this. Okay. So first what we will do, we will find out the volume of earth dug out. Okay. So volume is equals to volume of earth dug out. Volume of earth dug out is equals to pi r square h. So equals to 22 by 7 multiplied by radius. Diameter is given 10, so radius will be 5 into 5 into height is 14. Okay, so 7 2s are 14, 110, and it will be 1100 meter cube. This is the volume of earth dug out. Okay, now what we will do, we need to find out volume of this. Volume of this, but this is a spherical shell. Okay, so you will get there two different radius. Understood? So we will say for that volume 2, we will say volume 2 is equal to pi into h into r square minus r square, because two different radii you will get. So same formula you are using, but this is spherical shell, so we are using this. Understood? So now here it will be 22 by 7 multiplied by 14 by 3 multiply by r square, we don't know, outer radius we don't know, inner radius we know, that is 5 square. So it will be again 22 by 7 multiply by 14 by 3 into r square minus 25. So we can put in bracket. Okay, but this volume and the volume of earth dugout will be same. So I am going to take here 1100, which we got here. Okay, so now here we can do 7 2s are 14, 22 2s are 44, 44 upon 3 multiply by r square minus 25 is equal to 1100. So r square minus 25 is equal to 1100 multiply by 3 upon 44. So 11 4s are 44, 100. So here we can take 25, 25 3s are 75, 25 3s are 75. So r square minus 25 is equal to 75. So r square is equal to what? 75 plus 25. 75 plus 25. So r square is equal to 100. So r is equal to 10. Radius is 10. Means outer radius is 10. So they are asking width. Width means the difference between r minus small r. That is 10 minus 5 is equal to 5 meter. That is the width. So A is the correct answer. Okay. Now question number 70 is, if the radius of cylinder is 4 cm and height is 10 cm, then total surface area of cylinder. So very simple question. So directly we can write r is equal to 4 cm and height is equal to 10 cm. So total surface area we use 2 pi r, r plus h. Okay, so put the values here. 2 multiply by 22 by 7 multiply by 4 into r plus 7. R is 4 plus 10, it will equals to 14. So 7 2s are 14 and 22 2s are 44 and 4 2s are 8. So it will be 352 square centimeter. So B is the correct answer. Okay, so here 70 over. Now next, for 71, a cylinder, this is short answer, a cylinder radius is double and height is halved. Okay, radius is double and height is halved, the curved surface area of the cylinder will be, curved surface area of the cylinder will be, radius is double, curved surface area is equals to 2 pi rh, and radius is double. Now here see, 2 pi, radius is double means it will be 2 r, and height is halved, so h by 2. Okay, so this is new curved surface area. So again 2 will be cancelled. Again what is going to remain? 2 pi r h. Okay, so both the cases answer remains same. So answer is the same, will be the same. Okay, sir, same question is there in previous, means this only paper, but little bit difference is there. Okay, next question, the radius of the sphere is 7 cm. Radius of the sphere is 7 cm. Then what is the surface area of the sphere is, okay, surface area of the sphere is equals to 4 pi r square is equal to 4 multiplied by 22 by 7 multiplied by 7 into 7. So 7, 7 will be cancelled and this will be 688 multiplied by 7. 616 is the answer, okay, centimeter square. Okay, next question, 73, the lateral surface area of cube is 256 square centimeter. 256 square centimeter of cube. Okay, lateral surface area. Lateral surface area means what? We will say 4x cube. X square is equal to 256. So x square is equal to 256 divided by 4, it is 64. So x square is equal to 64. So x is equal to what? 8. And they are asking volume of cube. Volume of cube is equal to what? Side cube means x cube, that is 8 cube is equal to 512 meter cube. Okay, so that will be the answer. Now next, the number of planks of dimensions 4 meter into 50 centimeter into 20 centimeter that can be stored in a pit which is 16 meter long, 12 meter wide and 4 meter deep. Okay, so here required number of planks is equal to volume of pit divided by volume of a plank. Volume of plank. Okay, so volume of pit I will get, this is 4 meter, this, and this is 16 meter, 12 meter and 4 meter. Okay, answer we need to find out here. So that is 16 meter we can convert into 1600 multiply by 1200 multiply by 4 meter is 400 divided by this 4 meter will be 400 centimeter multiply by 50 centimeter multiply by 20 centimeter, because these are given in centimeter, these are given in meter. So we have to make under same unit. So that will be, when you will solve this, that time will get answer 4 4 16, so 1920 is the correct answer. And now question number 75, this is the last question. The length of the longest pole that can be put in a room of dimensions 10 meter into 10 meter into 5 meter. Okay, so length of pole is equals to length of diagonal of room is equals to, how to find out diagonal? Diagonal is equals to L square plus B square plus H square. Okay, so now here the diagonal of a cuboid, this is, so 10 square plus 10 square plus 5 square, length, breadth and height is given. So 10 square is 100 plus 100 plus 25, it will be 225 is equals to 15 meters. So that is the correct answer. Okay, so this was the discussion about today's paper. Paper was very easy. This was the first time we are trying on the Google form. So the paper was given very simple. Okay, so thank you very much.